here with Daniel at KubeCon Paris 2024, and we're here to talk about everything technology. So Daniel, what is the core messaging for edge technology? What would you say is the messaging for that?
That's a really tough question. So I would say there is no one size fits all, and each edge problem space and each kind of use case, like being an industrial predictive maintenance in retail point of sale solution, every solution or every problem space has different constraints. For example, sometimes it's space and power and cooling, sometimes it's networking or network bandwidth, and that is really a challenge. So there is no one simple one solution fits all, and that is why I love and our capabilities, because based on Kubernetes we try to provide a really consistent platform from small via medium to large. I try to avoid the word cloud native workload, because if you run on the edge, it is cloud technologies, but it is not a typical cloud. So I call this more modern applications like microservices, event driven, AI, machine learning world. But still, for example, I try to avoid the word legacy workload. I call this more the traditional workload, which is still running in a virtual machine, because that's perfectly fine. I mean, maybe you have a 10-year-old golden monolith which you can't easily refactor, and maybe it's even not worth the effort. So you run it in a virtual machine co-located to your container technology, to your modern stuff. And that should run on a small edge device, in your small data center, in a big data center, in the cloud. It should be consistent. And that's what we provide with OpenShift. And it's really fun to see a lot of customers using that as a new abstraction layer, kind of the new operating system. I mean, Kubernetes is kind of the new operating system, not only in the data center or in the cloud, in the hybrid cloud, but also even on the edge. Which, if you think about where Kubernetes is coming from, is totally, it's insane. I mean, it has been invented to run thousands, tens of thousands of nodes in a cloud. That's where it has been born, and now it's running on a single node small system, yeah? And it works, it's possible, you can do that, and that's really unbelievable.
What are some things you're looking forward to, up and coming technologies and things that Red Hat is working on, and things that you're excited about with future technologies?
Yeah, so it's really fun to see, for example, in the discussion I have with my product management friends, from OpenShift AI, to align. Currently there is such a myriad of different open source project technologies where we need to find out which ones will hit the community, which one will kind of be the de facto standard. It feels a little bit like with Kubernetes like 5-6 years ago, where there was a question, okay, which container orchestration technology is going to prevail? Now we know it has been Kubernetes. In the AI space, we are going to see something similar now, and we have to wait and watch the communities, which one get most adoption, and then make sure that this is nicely integrated into one holistic solution which covers the whole life cycle. And really it is a cycle, because you have to constantly do this, like with DevOps. So that's going to be really interesting to see in the next couple of 2 years how this works out.
Great, exciting stuff up and coming, and great chatting with you, Daniel.
See you at the booth.